I discovered the Cuttlelola Dotspen at a trade show, and the moment I saw it, it vaulted right to the top of my must-buy list. Unlike a ballpoint or felt tip pen, or really any pen at all, they produce a single mark each time you touch them to a surface. The Dotspen produces dots, many of them. With two speeds, the pen can quickly produce long sweeping lines or create wonderfully fine details. The Dotspen is packaged in this nice sturdy metal box. When you flip open the lid, you'll see inside the pen, black ink refills. In the back here is going to be your charging cable, and we'll talk about that in 1 second. Right now what's available are black ink. Colors will be coming, so you're going to get one ink cartridge in the pen and 5 extra ones here. The ink is permanent when it's dry. You can either let it dry naturally, or you can hasten that process with a heat tool, and then it's obviously, again, it's permanent when it's dry. So this is the pen. If you take off this protective cap on the end, you'll find this is the pen tip, the regular part that you would expect to see if you had any pen in your hand. Up here you're going to see this is where you're going to plug the charger in, and then there's this on-off button. So let's talk about the charging for 1 second. A full charge will give you about 30 minutes working time. You might recognize this. This is kind of a standard USB connector, and I think this is called a micro USB. You're going to plug this into your laptop or if you have a computer, whatever you have that has a USB slot in it, you'll plug that in there. And then you're going to, well, this is a little tangled. You're going to plug the micro end into the top of the pen. Always helps to turn it the right way. Now this is not lit at the moment because this is not actually plugged into any power supply, but when it is plugged in, this will light up as it's charging, and when it's fully charged, the light will go off. Off the top of my head, I don't remember how long it takes, maybe 40 minutes or so. Having said that, you can leave this plugged in here. You can have your laptop nearby and plug this into the laptop, and you can work sort of off electricity, and then you don't have to worry about, you know, the charge reducing to the point where it needs to be recharged again. So very straightforward, very easy to do. Let's talk about how you use the pen. Let's kind of slide this stuff out of the way. So as you look at the pen, again, here's the tip down here. This is the body of the pen. This little gadget right here, that's your on-off button. Very easy to use. A single push is going to give you low speed on the pen. You can see that tip moving up and down now. If I want to move to high speed, I'm going to quickly press this red dot twice, and that's going to increase the speed to high. When I want to lower the speed back down to that slow speed, 2 more quick presses and the pen slows back down. And then if you want to turn it off, a single press will stop it. So that's the basics. I want to show you just a few things. This is just an introductory video. I want to show you the basics about how to use it, and then I think you're going to discover that this is really an amazing tool. Let's get to the good part, using the pen. This is just a piece of 90-pound watercolor paper, and I'm going to start working with the pen on low speed, which means I'll start it with a single click of the red button. Now, the one thing that you'll notice as you work with it and as you see me work with it here today is that hand speed is how fast you move that pen on the area of the paper that you're working on is going to affect how closely the dots are spaced together. The faster you move your hand, especially if you're, well, it doesn't matter on either speed, but the faster you move your hand, the further apart the dots are going to be. Now that's going to vary in terms of placement depending on whether or not you're on low or high speed, and you'll see that. So let's start with a single push of the power button to get the pen operating on low speed. And I'm not going to talk while I do this because I'm not good at it, not talking and doing this at the same time. So you hear the tip of the pen, this is wood underneath my nonstick craft sheet, you hear the tip of the pen touching the surface of the paper. And you'll get the feel for keeping the pen tip at about the same height, but you'll find occasionally as you learn, you're going to lift a little bit and suddenly the lines won't, or the dots won't actually be there. Now let's watch what happens when I move my hand more quickly. See how further apart these dots are as opposed to if I go slowly? In fact, if I go slow enough, I could almost make a solid line. So think about the possibilities. Let's say this is the center of a flower, and I want to go ahead and I want to do some shading on one side. you can see how easy it is to go ahead and do that. I can get this density of dot or density of color very easily just by moving the pen more slowly. So let's say now I'm going to click the power button up here twice in succession quickly, and I'm going to now move to high speed. All right, so there's that tip moving much faster. Now watch what happens. Again, the more quickly I move my hand, the further apart the dots are going to be. So that's it. Those are really the basics. I have a couple other things that I want to show you, but let me get myself set back up. I want to show you how you can take a drawing, whether it's something that you've already sketched out or if you just want to draw freehand. I want to show you how easy it is to take that sketch and convert it to a really beautiful drawing. You can work with this pen in so many ways. I'm going to start with just a very simple sketch of a flower. I put the stem and a couple of leaves in off to the side. The center is there, and I've started to think about how I want to make some very simple petals. So I'm going to start with the pen on low speed, and I'm going to start in the center of the flower. So a single click will get the pen moving on low speed, and that's going to be perfect for doing this center. And just as simple as that, it's done. So what I want to do for the bits of the flower are just going to be some very straightforward straight lines with some circles on the end. And again, low speed is the perfect speed for me to do this. All right, so I've shown you how easy it is to do this. This is not rocket science, but it's one of those things that you thought, my goodness, why didn't I think of this before? It's just a marvelous invention. So I want to do the stem and the leaves and these little pieces coming off the side, and I want to do that on high speed because I'm going to move my hand fairly quickly so I get really nice, even, graceful curves, or theoretically I'm going to get graceful curves. So two clicks, and now the pen is moving at high speed, and my hands make curves better this way, so that's how I'm going to do this. So there's my stem. Now you'll notice that I did not follow my lines exactly, but it really doesn't make any difference. They're just there as a guideline anyway. And realistically, this is probably not a great perfect leaf on there or a stem with a leaf off of it, but this is just for demonstration purposes. If you decide that you don't want to draw anything, you don't want to sketch anything, these work really well with stamped images. If I wanted to alter this flower, I could do that. If I wanted to add some really fun curly tendrils, I could do that too. I'm going to do it on high speed. This is Virginia England's, one of her funky flowers. I don't recall, there's a little bug on there, not anymore. I don't recall which one of them it is. I want to say that it's five or six. So I'm just going to show you. You can see that she's already got some dots in here that kind of darken and make shading on the center of the flower. I'm going to show you how I can do that along the petals, and then I'll show you how I can do some tendrils. So I'm going to go for low speed, and then two more clicks will put it up on high. Actually, you know what? I think low speed is going to be better for this. I just want to add a little bit of shadow along the edge of the petals. I can certainly do that. You see how easy it is, again, and how marvelously simple this tool is, but how effective it is. So if I want to do tendrils, now I do want to be on high speed. So I'm imagining a tendril that kind of starts here and is going to come up like this. So it's going to be behind this leaf, it will display here, and then it will be behind the petal and come out up here. How easy is that? You can get these wonderfully graceful lines with virtually no effort at all. So, two clicks for low speed, a single click to shut it off. This is the Cuttlelola Dotspen, and I think that it is a marvelous product.